Hello students, now let us see Odisha State Board Mathematics, that is indefinite integral, exercise 7.D, question number 2. The first bit is integration dx by 3x square plus 7. I already told you in the indefinite integration, under that trigonometric substitution, whenever you find your integration format as x square plus a square, then in such case you have to take x equal to a tan, x equal to a tan theta. This is the rule. Fine. So here, so let what we have to assume that my x, x is here what, the way I can write it as dx by this 3x, can I write it as root 3x whole square plus 7. Can I write it as root 7 whole square? So now what is my x here? Root 3x equal to a is root 7 tan. Yes or no? Clear? Now differentiate this with respect to x. What you will find? Root 3 dx equal to root 7. Differentiation of tan theta is secant square theta. Now substitute it here. So now what is our integration? Dx you want. So take this root 3 divided by this side. Take it outside. Root 7 by root 3 secant square theta d theta. This is your numerator dx part completed. Coming to denominator part. Now denominator root 3x square. So what I will write? Root 7 tan theta whole square. Plus this is a root 7 whole square. Now this is, you check root 3 by root 7, root 7 by root 3. In the denominator root 7 is common, that is square. So I will take it outside. So root 7 square. Now in the numerator part, it is secant square theta d theta integration divided by. What is denominator now? Tan square theta plus 1. What is tan square theta plus 1? Secant square theta. So this get cancelled. Now it is 1 by root 21. Now what is integration of d theta? Theta plus c. Now 1 by root 21. What is my theta? See from this. Divide this by this side. So what I will get? Root 3x by root 7. Now theta equal to tan inverse root 3x by root 7. So tan inverse root 3x by root 7 plus c. Answer. Yes sir, no, clear. Now come to the second part, second question, that is e to the power 4x e to the power 8x by 4. Can I write it in the same format? E to the power 4x divided by e to the power 4x square plus 2 square dx. Clear? Now this is in which format? The same way you can assume it as e to the power 4x. As t, if you assume e to the power 4x as t, now differentiate it with respect to x, e to the power 4x differentiation is 4. Now apply chain rule, 4x differentiation is 4 dx equal to dt. Now my numerator part is e to the power 4x dx. So what I will do, I will take this 4, write it in the right hand side denominator. So now my numerator will becomes dt, this 1 by 4, I will take it outside, divided by, what is my e to the power 4x? T square plus 2 square. Clear? Now, you can see, it is in coming in this format. 1 by integration of a square plus x square. What is the formula for it? If it is coming in this format, directly you write, first write the formula, integration of dx by x square plus a square equal to 1 by a tan inverse x by a. This is the formula. Now it is, instead of x it is t, instead of a it is 2. So what I'll write? 1 by 4. Now what is my a? A is 2, so 1 by 2 tan inverse. What is my x is t by a is 2 plus. Now 1 by 8 tan inverse. What is my t? E to the power 4x by 2 plus c. Answer. So simple. Yes or no? Now let us see the third bit. See, from the question itself, if you assume ln x as t, then differentiation of ln x is 1 by x. That is present. So simple. So what you do? Assume first, let ln x equal to t. Now differentiate with respect to x. Differentiating with respect to x. So what you will get? 1 by x dx equal to dt. Now it is already present here. You can substitute it. What you can write? Dt by ln x is my t. So t square plus 5 square. Now it is in the same format. Yes or no? Right. So what I'll write? 1 by a is my 5 tan inverse t by 5 plus c. Now 1 by 5 tan inverse. What is my t? T is ln. So ln x by 5 plus c. Clear? Now coming to this question, can I do it directly by using this formula? Yes, I can. How the way? Now you have to bring this into this format. Now how to bring it? Just I'll show you. What you do? Dx by, your target is you want x, but it is given as 3. So divide by 3 multiplied by 3. So if you divide by 3 multiplied by 3, now keep this 1 by 3 as this 1, 1 by 3 can we write it as? Now this is 3, 1 by 1 by x is x. Clear? So I multiplied by 3, divided by 3. Now this is 3x square plus 7. So can I write it as integration dx by, this 3, 3 get cancelled. So x square 7 by 3, yes or no? Keep this 1 by 3 outside dx by, this is x square, this 7 by 3. Can I write it as root 7 by 3 whole square? Clear? Easy or not? Easy method. Now it is in this format. This is after all a constant. So keep it outside. Now what you have to write? 1 by a. So 1 by a means my 7 by root 3 whole root tan inverse. What is my x? Divided by a. A is root 7 by root 3 plus c. So now you see it will be 1 by root 21 tan inverse root 3 x by root 7 plus c. Check the cross verification, same answer or not? Very easy or not? You should know the technique. Now similarly here, you see what I have to assume as substitution so that the part will be present in numerator. I can assume at secant theta. So let my secant theta equal to t. So what is differentiation of secant theta? That will be secant theta into tan theta d theta equal to dt. Now this part is directly in the numerator is present as dt. So substitute dt by, now what is my secant theta t? So t square 4. Can I write it as 2 square? Directly in this format, dx by x square plus a square. So what will be the answer? 1 by t tan inverse x is t by 2 plus c. Now 1 by what is my t? So secant theta, sorry, 1 by a. This is 1 by a, so 1 by 2. 1 by 2 tan inverse. What is my t? Secant theta by 2 plus c. Answer. Correct or not? Very easy or not? So please work out and practice so that you will have clarity of how to do the integration by trigonometric substitution. Okay students, take care. In my next video, I will upload from, this is up to IV, from V to V triple I. Okay students, till then take care. Bye-bye.